Kelly, former Detective Daniel Hersl is the sixth GTTF member to be sentenced in this case. Today, getting one of the more stiffer penalties of 18 years behind bars. In a last-ditch effort, former Detective Daniel Hersl argued a motion for a new trial based on the credibility of one of the witnesses against him. It was denied. Federal prosecutors said it had no bearing on what they called the disgraced officer's acts of sadism on Baltimore residents, that his role in the robbery and extortion ring, as well as a massive overtime fraud, proved he devalued people and made a chump of the city taxpayer. They asked for 20 years behind bars. Hersl's attorney countered with statements from his brothers and sister, as well as excerpts from letters he's been writing from jail. They showed pain, faith, and love for his 10-year-old son and his family. Hersl himself did not take the opportunity to address the court before Judge Catherine Blake settled on 18 years in prison.
I believe that Judge Blake had her basis for giving this particular sentence, and she articulated on the record. Am I happy with the sentence? The answer is no, but I think I understand the reason for the sentence.
The reason, the judge said, was the abuse of public trust and the immense collateral damage it caused in Baltimore. The sentence had to send a clear message. It matched that of former detective and Hersl's only co-defendant, Marcus Taylor, who was also found guilty by a jury in February. Hersl now joins six of his former colleagues who have been sentenced. His brother Stephen outside court today in tears over the fate of his youngest brother.
We heard today from the family and from Danny's supporters that we love him. We'll always love him. We miss him tremendously.
The final two GTTF members yet to be sentenced are former detectives Gondo and Ram. Hersl's attorney said today that he does indeed plan to appeal.